Hello and welcome back to XCOM Chimera Squad. I fortunately managed to finish the mission, but unfortunately, due to the game crash, we lost a bit of footage there. OBS didn't like it. I still felt I wanted to have a proper finishing screen and catch you up with what happened. Not very surprisingly, we just basically overpowered the last three enemies. I just fired up the save game again, which would bring you back into the game, but by ending the very first day, you're going back to the victory screen. Chimera Squad itself is concluded with that. And whilst we're looking at the final title here, I wanted to give a bit of an overview about my thought process regarding the game. So I'll make this here more a video around what is working well in Chimera Squad and what are my overall thoughts about it. Let's start with the good, then we're going to the bad and the ugly, and then kind of a final verdict or assessment. So overall, Chimera Squad was an experimental game. I think it was very well positioned as a commercially cheap title with a lot of tests for mechanics. Where the player base can give feedback. So let's go through the most important ones and see at least what my opinion is about it. And I invite you to leave your opinion down as well. First thing first, obviously, Chimera Squad has a completely different appeal. So mechanically, you are given a couple of pre-generated characters, and I do understand that is not everyone's favorite approach to the game. The customization of the characters was pretty like straightforward and not very in-depth. So that's of course a shortcoming, but for a low-budget $5 title, that's exactly, or $10 title, that's pretty much exactly what you could expect. And I think the characters themselves were absolutely well done. Talking about game balance, I like the fact that this game has upped the bottom a little bit. Squaddy characters could actually do something as opposed to normal XCOM 2 or XCOM 1 characters, where squaddies are basically just cannon fodder. They kept the ceiling where it's supposed to be. I was very surprised that you could basically put every four characters together and still make the combination work. Which shows that the game difficulty was probably not high enough to really flush out the absolute top tier characters from the just very good characters. But B, it also shows that the characters in general were decently well balanced with their abilities. One thing that I personally completely liked, and where I think they took a step in the right direction, was the equipment design. We still do have stronger equipment, but the equipment is very niche functional. So you don't have just omnipotent items that you always would take. I think the movement to making consumables a free action is absolutely correct. They should definitely include that in the normal game as well, because it incentivizes taking more consumables. The static items like ammunition specifically usually dominated the normal impossible or legendary Iron Man runs in XCOM 2. So moving towards freely usable items, I think that was a great idea. I liked a lot of the grenades that they've put in. So that was refreshing to see. Probably it would have probably been a good idea to give more utility slots, just because there was such a breadth of items and you couldn't take two grenades anyway. So I think that there was a bit room for improvement. Moving on to the 500-pound gorilla in the room, which is the move away from the actual initiative order. I think the new initiative order with a mixed initiative got rid of an important problem that XCOM 1 and 2 had, which is the alpha strike nature of the game. No longer can you just simply annihilate the entire team, enemy team, without them even doing something. I like the mixed initiative order way better than Long War's approach, where I was often frustrated with the fact that the enemy could simply shoot back and like you had no counterplay whatsoever. I think it was overall fair. It gave a new level of tactical depth. Limiting factors for it had been only that I think some of the abilities were just way stronger than others. And overall, the mixed initiative at least felt for me like very much like a swinging game. As soon as you had the enemy cornered into one corner, you could essentially just use them as a punching bag, and the encounter was over almost after the first two rounds. Very seldomly it has taken longer than that. Anyways, I think an interesting concept. I could definitely see parts of that included in XCOM as well. The downside of the mixed initiative is the alpha strike nature of XCOM 2 also made it more unforgiving, which I personally like. So specifically in an Iron Man run, I noticed that the mixed initiative here, a good player, you need to make the game much, much more difficult to actually bring someone to their limit in the mixed initiative, because you always have kind of a safety net or two. Moving on to the squad limitation for characters and 8 out of 11 characters, I think overall from a replayability standpoint, makes sense that they don't give you all of the characters right away. I think that's okay and fair. Like I already said, every character worked well with every other character. That's good. For characters, I personally like smaller squads. With the mixed initiative, it never felt that you had too little characters. So I could see having 4 characters being the standard again. I think with moving towards more the Long War, 6, 8 and even 10 characters, it gets very sluggish. It's a large, very large map then, and each to their own. I personally always liked clever thought processes with less pieces on the board instead of massive just slugfests and AoE damage with more pieces, but I can warm up to both ideas, so 4 was definitely not a hurdle. Character strength in general and difficulty of the game. Like I said, the character bottom had been elevated. The character strength in the endgame was incredibly high. It felt like the enemies had absolutely nothing to put against us. Even unique enemies were easily defeated. The items were so strong that due to the very limited amount of encounters per run, you always had a chance to just outgun the enemy massively. I think the overall difficulty needs to be reassessed. I'm not sure if they didn't have enough playtesting available, but on a almost blind playthrough for the second half of this one here, with an impossible hardcore run, impossible Iron Man hardcore run, to stomp the enemy that massively did not feel like they have done a really good job in balancing the game for the higher level difficulties. And I get it, not everyone wants to play on that level of difficulty, but we're talking deliberately on the highest level difficulty. I can't speak for the other levels. So there is no easy solution, but I would probably guess deeper talent pools for the enemies would probably solve some of that. For instance, Sorceress only had Null Lens and Tyranny, and whenever no proper target for their Thrall ability was available, they started to take shots with their gun. That for me is a problem of game design on the higher difficulty, and also the amount of enemies was simply not enough. Probably you would have needed to bring in more reinforcements more regularly just to make it interesting. After the first round, the game usually swung very much into our direction. Yeah, and then finally, a couple of other points regarding my first impression. I think the overall appeal, the depth of the story, the background, the mission design was very well done. So I congratulate the team for doing such a good job there. The breach mechanic is probably noticeable as one of the new mechanics as well. Shouldn't forget about that. Is much better than the Overwatch mechanic. The Overwatch mechanic in XCOM and XCOM 2 specifically on the higher level difficulties was not really a compelling mechanic because you couldn't choose the targets, and oftentimes you were giving something up, i.e. a second action per turn, and so on and so forth. I think with breach items, offering a new item slot, and the op option to actually act within Overwatch, you could have completely saved and remodeled the entire Overwatch and concealment dynamic of XCOM and XCOM 2, or XCOM 2 rather. There was no concealment in XCOM 1. So of XCOM 2, imagine if you start a concealment Overwatch trap and you basically can choose the targets yourself, and even use special abilities in some of the case. I think that would be really, really well received. So I think that one was probably one of my favorite features of the entire game. And finally, to round everything up, the overall balancing and appeal of the game was, I would say, good. They probably could have done a bit more game balancing. I did not feel that everything worked out well. And probably my biggest point of criticism, let's spend a minute with that as well, is that there are a lot of game bugs. I don't know why they released the game right now. It felt almost a bit rushed, and I don't know why that is necessary. I can't imagine that Firaxis was running out of money on a lower budget production, and proper game testing would have helped. Just to name a couple of examples, the running into cover mechanic in the breach phase like worked less, if not none of the times. I had the weapon bug at times. The number of nanomed kits just exploded to 50-ish. Abilities were unbound and couldn't be rebound. We saw the reinforcements bug that apparently was somewhat fixed. Some abilities crashed in the breaching piece. Just generally, game crashes and unstable builds. I would say overall, it feels more like a late beta test and not so much like a final release. Again, I know that that will change over the course of the next month, so I'm not too harsh on it. But still, I mean, for a first playthrough, I would have expected a bit better release. And that has been it. That's our first Chimera run. I will do another one offline to just to understand the last few operatives and agents, and then I'll create a couple of guides as always around the game. So stay tuned. There's going to be a bit more Chimera content. What I would like to ask you, if you've seen that video here, is not only to like the content, but also to give your personal opinion about the game in the comments, and more importantly, let me know if you want to see more Chimera squad content. At the moment, not many mods are out there, but I can sit down and tune the game to be substantially more difficult. It will take some time, but if you're interested in seeing a substantially more difficult run, then be my guest and just go ahead, write it down, and we can see if I can realize that. I thank you for your attention and for your viewership. This brings us to the end of the Chimera Squad run. That has been XCOM 2 Chimera Squad Impossible Iron Man Hardcore, hardest difficulty with all of the hardest mods enabled. First try success, albeit with working around all of the bugs. Thank you, and see you in the next run. Bye-bye.